All right, it's Wednesday, July the 21st, 2010, and this is your Daily Dose. My camera seems to be doing some weird color stuff today, but must be because I got a birthday gift somebody gave me. I'm sorry, somebody got me. Get up, stand up for your right shirt. Definitely what I'm going to do. But what we got today to start it off is we got some quotes. And the first quotes we have are going to come from Ernest Hemingway, our deceased birthday boy. And the first quote says, "I know only that what is moral is what you feel good after, and what is immoral is what you feel bad after." So a little while ago this morning, when I was able to help somebody that's suffering from terminal pancreatic and cancer of the liver, and I was able to help them by giving them some cupcakes and some pre-rolled medicine cannabis cigarettes, I felt good. In fact, I'm getting goosebumps now thinking about it, how good I felt. I felt fabulous, because that gentleman that thinks he's only got 5 to 6 more months of life left instantly had a sense of relief in his face that there was somebody here to help him. He wasn't alone. He wasn't in pain. For a split second there, he was able to realize somebody was here to help. And I'm fortunate enough that I was able to be that person. Next quote we have says, "Happiness in intelligent people is the rarest thing I know." Well, it's simple, because those of us with any form of intelligence or common sense see the problems in the world, and we see that they need to be fixed. And because we are intelligent, we can't sit back and watch. And that's why I'm involved with the medical cannabis issue. Not only does it help me and my life, but there are many others out there that aren't able to speak up in the manners that I'm able to. So I'm going to use those blessings to speak on their behalf. And that's what I'm going to do. Which leads to the next quote. And it says, "I never had to choose a subject. My subject rather chose me." Trust me, when I was in high school, I never once would have thought about using cannabis. It wasn't in my DNA. It wasn't in my nature. I was healthy. I was an athlete. I was successful in sports. I was doing well in school. I was doing everything I needed to do to get to where I needed to be. And then my health started to fail. I started to get injured. And cannabis chose me because I had no other options. When I was laying there like a vegetable on the couch eating pills, trying to figure out a better way to be the same person, to try to stop the people that came up and said, "Dude, he's not the same guy anymore." I had to put an end to those people that were saying things like that. Cannabis helped me do that. The last quote says, "I like to listen. I have learned a great deal from listening carefully. Most people never listen." Our politicians haven't been listening. Hopefully with the news story that's ran, they will start to listen. I once again want to thank Channel 8 for running the piece. It's personally helped me in that in just the last 24 hours, requests for interviews, TV appearances, so on and so forth have been amazing. I'm flattered. I'm truly humbled. And I hope that this helps to not only allow me more venues to speak at, but it will also give encouragement to the people sitting at home right now that tune in every day to watch what I'm saying. Give them the encouragement to start saying the things that they think, the things that they feel, and getting it into the ears of the people that need to hear it. It's real simple. If we tell politicians to do their job and they don't do it, then we tell them, "Hey, guess who we voted for next election? Not you." And I understand that some of us will pass between now and the next election or the election after that and things of that nature. And it's painstaking dealing with bureaucrats and bureaucracy. But hey, that's the way this great, glorious country was set up. So we have to do it that way. And we're going to do it that way. But at the same time, we're not going to be immoral. I'm not going to be less than human. And I'm not going to let people suffer that shouldn't be suffering. Or I'm not going to let people suffer that are suffering merely because some legislation didn't get written the way it was supposed to get written 10 years ago. Now, with that being said, we're going to wrap it up for today. Real quick, you know, we have our quotes. What I wanted to talk about, one, thank you for the story that Channel 8 did. Two, I want to remind everybody, there's a protest going on in San Diego today about the DEA raids and the tactics being used in federal courts. I would encourage everybody to open your eyes, open your mind, open your mouths. Start being heard. Start telling people, let the states that have medical marijuana laws implement them. Stop trying to decide that for whatever reason you don't like it, and you're just going to go ahead and call up the feds and have them come make it even more confusing. It's that simple. It's that simple. People hear me say that all the time. It's that simple. we could iron this out in literally one day. I guarantee you I could come up with a ploy real simple that would get everybody that needed to be in that room in the room. Law enforcement, district attorney, mayor, governor, all of them. All of them. Get them all in a room. And make them sit there and say, okay, common sense. We allow patients to have this, but we give them no way to get it. So if we don't give them a way to get it, where do they go? The illicit market. Well, that's illegal. We need to stop that. I mean, it's common sense. I just did it in like 10 seconds. But anyway, we need more people other than myself getting those feelings out there. And hopefully with the radio interviews, some TV appearances, things like that, we'll be able to do so. I hope that everybody's having a great week thus far. It's another wonderful hump day. The week's almost over. For anybody out there that's been wondering about certain things, let me grab something for you real quick. As we go off the camera, we just wanted to show people. They're flying, but you know, of course we have the cupcakes. I have these pre-rolls. I keep these here for when patients come in and they have troubles or whatnot. Never know when you're going to need a pre-roll. But to make a long story short, we're doing the best we can to evolve and to become what our licenses allow us to do, and also to try to work with the city to be able to do the things we're not allowed to do. And right now, what we're not allowed to do is we are not allowed, or I am not allowed, to provide cannabis to patients legally for remuneration. What that means is this. I can pay for the nutrients, I can pay my electric bill, I can pay my water bill, I can work my ass off 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, 365 days a year, but I'm not allowed to reimburse myself for my effort, my expertise, or anything as it pertains to cannabis. It makes no sense. Our state allows people to use it. It allows people to grow it. And for those that can't, I should be allowed to supply them and recoup my costs and recoup what I'm worth. It's that simple. People pay appearance fees to celebrities to show up at a pool. They pay them tens of thousands of dollars. So if I have knowledge that's worth somebody's life, technically speaking, people that need this to live, this is worth their life, and they're not going to allow me to show people, teach people, provide to people, it makes no sense. That's ignorance. That's adult ignorance, and they should be ashamed of this. Any adult that